In this video, we're going to learn about what is a BFS with an example of an informal algorithm. So, what is graph traversal? Traversing a graph means visiting each and every vertices of graph exactly once. Your graph traversal can start from any vertex of the graph. Out of several graph traversing algorithms, two algorithms are mostly accepted and as a standard. So these are DFS, depth first search traversal, and second is BFS, that is breadth first search traversal. For this we need the data structure as queue. So let's understand queue, what we do and how we proceed in the queue. Suppose this is example of ticket booking section. So here what we are doing, the element, or we can say if this person enters, now this person is entering into the queue or in the line at the last time. So if all of this person get ticket, only then he can come out of this particular line or queue. So here we can say that this is the rear part of the line and this is the front part of the line. Okay, from where the ticket near to that we are having a ticket counter. Okay, from this particular place we are getting the ticket. Now from the front we are getting ticket, and when the task of this person is completed, it will come out of the line. So the same thing is there in the queue is there. Always new or the last person enters from here in the queue, and from the front, the first person who entered in the line will get the ticket first and will come out of the line. So this is, if this is the first person, he will get the ticket and he will come out. Yes, I got ticket, I will come out of the line. So this is your first in and first out. So this operation is called as a DQ. And if you want to, if new person want to enter into that particular line, so he must enter from the last of the line. Otherwise, this all person will shout like, hey, this is the line, you have to enter from the last of the last line. So this operation is called as an enqueue, where you are just entering from the last of that particular line, from the rear of that line. So as we can observe here, the person which were in the line for the first time at the first place took the ticket and came out for the first. So this is called as a first in and first out. So this is what we use in the queue. So the data structure which we use for the BFS is queue, and the thing in which we follow the BFS, breadth first search, is we first visit any vertex V. Then we try to visit all its adjacent vertex. After writing all of its adjacent vertex, we just take one adjacent vertex and we just write all its adjacent vertex and continue till the end of the graph. So for example, if I'm having vertex A, so I will visit this vertex A, and for vertex A, there are this two vertex are adjacent to vertex A. So I will write both of these vertex at the same time. Now in the list, this vertex is not yet visited, so I will just try to explore this vertex B and I will find out all its adjacent vertices. So that is C. So C will be written over here. Now we have completed this much portion. Now G is not yet explored, so we'll try to get all of its adjacent vertex of G. So that is F. So this list will continue. And if you will carefully look what we are doing, we are just level wise, we are arranging all of these nodes. So this is also called as a level wise traversal. And let's see example of BFS with the help of an informal algorithm. For this we need a data structure, that is queue. So we are using name for the queue as queue, and each vertex has three states. Now for example, if we are having this vertex, now to maintain it in the queue, so we will keep the three state for the vertex, that is ready state, waiting state and process state. Ready state means it is initial state, waiting state means it is in the queue waiting for processing, and process state means it is written into this particular list and it has been processed. So what is the algorithm for that? Let's see that by using one example. So here the algorithm is initialize all nodes to ready state. So we have initialized all nodes to the ready state. This is our queue. Now place starting node A in queue and change its state to waiting state. So now we have picked this from the ready state, we have changed its state to waiting state. Repeat step 4-5 until queue is empty. Now what is step 4-5? We have to look. So remove front node of X of queue, process that node and change its state to process state. So what we are doing, we will remove this, okay. We will process it, and now we have removed this, so we will change its state to process. So this is processed node. Now to process this means what? We have to insert. Now fifth step is we have to insert all of its adjacent neighbors in ready state to rear of the queue. Means we have to see what are the adjacent nodes are there for vertex A which are in the ready state. So that is B and G, and which is not yet inserted into this queue. So this is not yet inserted into the queue. So we will try to insert that particular nodes in the queue. So we will insert B and G in the state. Now as they have entered into this queue in this particular line, so we will change its state to waiting state. So we have changed this thing. Okay, now this thing will be get repeated for each and every of this vertex. Now we will remove this vertex. Now this step will continue. This vertex will be get removed and its state is changed to process state. Now for vertex B, what are the all adjacent nodes we are having? That is C. C will be inserted over here. That is in the ready state. So that will be inserted. Its state will be changed to waiting state. Now at the front we are having vertex G. Now this will be removed from that particular queue. All the adjacent vertex of G will be searched, that is F. Now F is still in the ready state, so that will be inserted into this particular queue. So this C is at the front of your queue, that will be taken out. And then for C, what are the adjacent vertices we are having, that will be inserted at the last of your queue. So that is E and D, which are in the ready state. E and D will be inserted over here. Now this F will be removed, which is in the waiting state, and we will convert its states to process state, and we will search for the nodes adjacent to F which are in the ready state. Now for F, vertex F, this is already processed, this is already processed. No other vertex is remaining which is adjacent to F which is in the ready state. So okay, we will leave it over here. Then we will search for what is another element you are having at the front of your queue. So that is this element. Now this will be taken out, will be kept over here, and it will be its state will be changed to process state. Now we will explore what are the adjacent nodes we are having for E which are not yet visited, that is D and F, which is now, this is not in the ready state, this is in the waiting state, and this is processed, so we cannot insert this two. Okay, we'll leave it over here. Now at the front of queue, D is there, so now we'll take out this D out. We'll keep this D and we'll change its state to process state. Now again we will look for what are the another nodes which are there in your queue whose state is in the ready state. So all these are processed nodes. No other nodes is there in your this particular graph which is adjacent to D and which is in the ready state. So this we cannot insert into it. So this queue becomes empty. So when your queue will become empty, you have to stop all of this processing. So that will be the end of your breadth first search traversal. So this is your answer, that is your breadth first traversal for this particular graph is ABGCFED, and the time complexity is big O of V plus E, where V is the total number of vertex and E is the total number of edges. So for example, for this particular graph, we want to do the breadth first traversal. So we will visit this node, then all the adjacent nodes to A will be visited. So that is B and C. Now here B is not yet explored, so all the adjacent node to B will be explored, that is D. Now C is not yet explored, so all the adjacent nodes to C will be explored, that is E and F. Now this for the D, there are no other adjacent nodes are there. For E also, for F also, there are no other adjacent nodes are there. So this is my particular breadth first traversal. So if you will carefully look, if you are having just simple tree, so you will just go from left to right level by level, from level 0 to level n, that will be your BFS.